Good morning, my dear students. Today let us discuss a small PPT presentation on commodity market and trading segments in commodity market. Previous class we already discussed regarding of the commodity market, some of the information I already gave, and little bit some of the extra required information I want to deliver. Through PPT, the BCom fourth semester students, you have a start on commodity market subject. The stock market subject we already discussed with the class session only. We only the pending in the commodity market concept. Definitely, I give the clear information and clear regarding commodity market subject. Okay, so all of you know that what is commodity market. So commodity market or market where raw or primary product are exchanged. For example, the raw material or primary product, for example, crude oil. So this is the one of the raw or primary product only we can consider over. It covers physical product, food, metals, electricity, or any other product also which is covered in the market. Basically, the commodity market we have deals within the Indian commodity stock exchange or commodity exchange also we are dealing with. Majorly in the commodity market we have classified the two commodity. We have modern commodity market have their roots in the trading agricultural products, and trading commodity include physical trading of food items, energy and metal, etc. So these are the major commodity thing. So let us go for classification of commodities. What are the major classification we have in the commodity market? Firstly, agricultural grains, pulses, oil seeds or spices, like these are all the agricultural products. As basis metal, copper, zinc, aluminium, nickel, tin. So these are all the basis of metal. Energy basis, crude oil, heating oil, natural gases, furnace oil, etc. Like these are all the major energy bases. Bullion, like these are all the gold, silver, etc. So these are all the major four classification basis of the commodity market. So in the commodity market, we are dealing with that agricultural base and the non-agricultural basis also. We are also dealing with the commodity market. Next, let us go for one by one. The first thing, energies. So what are the energies under the commodity we have? The major commodity we have consideration: crude oil, petroleum, byproducts of petroleum, heating oil, natural gases, coal, byproducts of petroleum, for example, diesel, oil, like these are all the major byproducts of the petroleum also dealing with. Heating oil and natural gases and coal. These are all the energies related commodity we have dealing with through online itself. Agricultural products. So here it is. We have some of the agricultural product: wheat, rice, corn, either it is soybean. These are all the major agricultural product. You have also another agricultural product, for example, rubber. Like another, we have like cotton, and either it is pulses related, jeera, pepper. Like these are all the major masala product. Also, we are dealing with the in the agricultural products since itself. Next thing, we go for soft commodity. That is only soft commodity only considered, purely agricultural commodity only considered. Coffee, cotton, sugar, orange, or cocoa. These are all the major soft commodity. A performance of the market. So some of the previous year, whatever the performance related, like whatever the commodity basis, we have some performance review in the commodity stock exchange. Return across various commodity in last 5 year we have. These are all the like crude oil related, ISPT was turmeric, jeera it is 94.21%, and let us go for gold 92.86%. So these are all the some of the major commodity, whatever the trading as well as return commodity or performing commodity, we are one of the graphical representation we have you just see and observe the whatever the commodity we have and whatever the major performance it is represented. Some of the negative also you have zinc and copper also we have negative cases. So that is also you have to observe. Next thing, types of market for commodity trading. So what are the types of market we have? What are the trading? What are the types of trading they have following that? In our fourth chapter, whatever the major trading process in the commodity market also you have. It is very, very important concept of spot trading, a future trading, forward trading, option trading, swap trading. So these are all the major trading segments in the commodity market. In which way they have trading in the commodity market, that only you have to consider. So firstly, let us discuss what is spot trading. Instant cash used in the physical exchange with commodity which passed from the seller and to user. So that is the instant cash basis as well as physically exchanging the goods and commodities. So that is only spot trading concept only we have to consider over. Next thing, forward market and future markets. It is very familiar concept, forward market and future market. Let us go for first thing, forward market and the future market are derived for trading of commodity in market. With a view of ascertaining the future value of the same commodity. Ultimately, the future value only you have to be ascertained in the present scenario. You have to be fixed after keeping view of the demand, climate in condition, fluctuation in currency, inflation. These are all the major factors to be influencing to making the contract to the forward market as well as future market. For example, after based on the demand basis also we are making a climate condition, sometime the weather condition or climate condition will be the fluctuate. So that situation, the product demand and supply also will be that a variation. For example, floods, earthquake, these are all the condition. The demand will be that increase, whether it is decrease, the price will be that constant and whatever the deliver the goods, the particular party itself. So that is a major purpose only we are making the forward contract. And fluctuation in currency, when we are importing as well as exporting the concept, we are exporting for any other country. So that time also the fluctuation of the currency situation also, we are making the forward as well as future market contracts. Sometimes of the inflation, in the cases of inflation, highly the demand will be increased, the supply will be decreased. So simultaneously price also will be that increase. So when we cannot affordable of the high price of the commodity. So that reason only precautionary we are making the forward market contract in the through the inflation purpose. Like. So these are all the major thing. Next thing, options trading. So what are the options you have? You have a two options. That is one is call option and another is put option. These are all the contract given the owner right, but not an obligation, but right to buy or right to sell. So in stock market only we already discussed it, right to buy option and right to call option. Basically we already ascertained that buy means for example call option. So when you buy the commodity, for example, you are predicting the commodity price will be increasing. So that prediction you always have to go for it is the call option. So then only you can get the return, it is possible. For example, when you come back with the put options, so when you it is a right to sell, for example, your prediction of the commodity, it is a decrease the value. So then only you have to take the position of the sell option as an asset. So this is the major options trading concept. Next one thing, swaps trading. These are the contracts exchange cash flow on before specified future date based on the underlying value of bonds, interest rates, currency exchanges, rate stock, commodity or other than assets. So this is another one of the commodity trading segment. The swap trading, these are the contract only deals with only currency exchange as well as bond as well as interest related commodity exchanges to all to be trading with the customers. Next thing, regulating of bodies. Basically, commodity market regulated by the Forward Market Commission, that is only FMC. I already told the FMC and SEBI nowadays will be that merged together, giving the guideline for all the stock market and commodity market trading process. So that related only you have to understand the major regulatory bodies in the commodity market, the FMC. The FMC, Forward Market Commission, it is completely controlled by the central government of central government. The central government in the which of the cabinet, like whatever the Ministry of Consumer Affairs. The Ministry of Consumer Affairs basically controlled by the FMC. The FMC basically controlled by the complete commodity market trading process. So that is only major thing. So when it is regulated, the term Section 15 Forward Contract Regulation 1952 Act will be imposed, as well as Forward Market Commission. Forward contracting commodity notice under Section 15 of the Act can be entered into only a member of recognized association. So this is the major recognized of the association only you have to be considered over in the forward market aspects. The recognized association commodity exchange are granted recognized under the Act Central Government. The recognized association means it should be the registered association. That registered association only deals with the commodity under the Central Government Act like. So all the exchanges which permit forward contract or trading are required open certificate or registration from the central government. So all the exchange permitted of the forward contract. So it is basically central government to be permitted to be exchanging the commodity to the customer in the forward market. Next thing we'll go for the other legislation which is have relevance commodity trading or and so what are the legislation we have? Companies Act, Stamp Act, Contract Act, Essential Commodity Act, Prevention of Food Adulteration Act, and various other legislation which impact on their working. So these are all the Companies Act you people are already learned in the corporate administration. Stamp Act you have to future you have to learn. Contract Act in your business regulation subject you have in the Contract Act, that is only you have to learn 1860, 1862, like whatever the Contract Act also you have to be deals with. Essentials Commodity Act 1955, like the Prevention of Food Adulteration Act 1954. So these are all the major act also will be legislating when the trading with the commodity because of prevention of food adulteration. Because the very simple thing, for example, I am purchasing any commodity, sometimes we will do the food adulteration will be that happen. That situation which is controlled this act majorly when we are purchasing as well as selling the commodity. So that is a major thing, purpose only we have. Next one is benefits of investing in commodity market. So what are the major benefits you have get when we are invest in the commodity market? So first thing, leverage. So leverage, all of you know that is a risk factor, it is very less. Ultimately you have to be maintain the proper ultimately you can expect the return from the commodity market. That reason also one of the major thing. A liquidity, ultimately that is a major thing. Liquidity means whatever the cash position also you can maintain with the particular customer itself, then only it is possible to when I invest in the commodity market, so possible to maintain the liquidity position. Diversification, ultimately we are investing the through the some alternative segment we are investing the money. For example, portfolio management, when I invest in the money in a different segment, for example gold, metal, cotton, wool, rubber, so these are all the crude oil, these are all various investing segment we have. So that is possible to diversify whatever the investment, whatever the money which is easily diversify for other segments. That is the diversification concept. Inflation hedge, so that is another one. Assurance of purity, so that is basically your people are getting the fair return policies from the commodity market. Transparency of rates, so which always maintain for the transparency and accurate price also we have to be maintained in the each and every commodity. Whatever the right market price only it is view and discover the pricing policies also which can easily control over the whatever the transparency of the pricing policies. That is one thing. Next one thing, preferential tax treatment than stocks. So that is basically ultimately you have to consider the tax treatment also when people are earned the commodity market. So that is ultimately in the stock market we are pay the whatever the tax amount. A risk associated with investment in commodity market. So ultimately also we have a risk. When we have a return, that return basis also we also face the risk. So first thing, price risk. If you know that price risk, the commodity market price, it is always volatility and fluctuating. Based on that also, you have to face the risk factor. A quantity risk, ultimately also expecting the quantity, whether it is commodity quantity, all the commodity quantity basis also you have to face the risk. Cost risk, that is the input price risk, that is also you have to consider. Ultimately, political risk. Some of the major changes of the government. So the government, once it can changes, ultimately the making the taxation policy or trading policies will be the changeover. So that time also you also face the political risk also. That is another one major risk also you have to face. Process of buying and selling products. So how it is to be buying and commodity as well as selling the commodity. That is only we can call it as trading process. In a commodity market, exactly what are the major trading process will be that happen. So first thing, we will go for market order. The customer chooses a specific commodity or commodity that he she wants to buy to or sell. So here it is, firstly, the customer has to decide, choose a specified commodity. For example, I want to purchase crude oil or gold or silver. So you have to mention it, whether it is soft commodity, whether it is hard commodity, whether it is agricultural commodity, whether it is non-agricultural commodity. Specifically, you have to mention which commodity you people are ready to buy or sell. So these are all the major. I have to be told when you people are right to buy, either it is right to sell. For example, if people are taking the call option, you have to always buy. Or whether it is you people are put option, right to sell. So these are all the major market position. When you are making as well as placing a order any commodity, so you have to take these two positions. So second thing, the customer chooses the number of contract that will deliver monthly. So that is the contract basis. For example, you people are weekly contract, we have quarterly contract, monthly contract basis, you people are, you have basis on the duration of periodical basis, you enter the contract. The contract will not have price on them. The contract will ultimately you have to consider the price, and time is priority, not price. So ultimately, in any contract, only priority we are giving, only the time basis. The time basis only you have to change over the pricing concepts. Next thing, second one thing, buy limit order. This order is only filled with specified price or better. This order specified price limit order will be filled. For example, I am purchasing whether it is call option, whether it is put option. Basis on this, you have to be set the price limits. Whether it is, for example, stop loss. So that is a, one of the major example. The stop loss also, why we are fixing the stop loss? All of you know that we are reducing the burden. We are reducing the loss. That only you have to fix the stop loss. So once we can fix the stop loss, ultimately you can reduce the risk. That is a major thing. The goal is buy lowest price possible for the commodity or commodities. Ultimately, the one of the major goal, any commodity or any stock you have to purchase, ultimately the lowest price. Why? Because of when you are purchasing the lowest price, ultimately suppose sometime the commodity will be that increased in a future time, ultimately you can get the return from the particular commodity itself. That reason only the buyer always be preferable only for the lowest price. A sell limit order, this order is only executed at the current market price or higher. Ultimately, when you people are ready to sell, for example, this, whatever the market price is there, that market price only you have to be sell the commodity or higher. Suppose the price will be that increase, then only you also sell the same product. The goal is to sell the commodity or commodity at the highest price. So ultimately, when you are purchasing the lowest price, when you are purchasing the lowest price, ultimately also selling the highest price. So this is the another one, sales limit order. Next thing, Indian commodity exchanges. Whatever the commodity exchanges we have, precious metal, gold, silver, like another metal, copper, lead, energy, crude oil, natural gases, fiber, raw, jute, other agro products, mento, oil, mineral, iron, so oil, seed complex. So these are all the Indian commodity, whatever the commodity we are dealing with. ultimately the tax implication, future contract or in the nature agreement to buy sell future date, and you are not liable for payment of that or sales tax. So it is a tax implication relating. So future contract is clause of settlement between the constitution future settlement date without actually buying selling the commodity. There is no liability for payment of tax. So this is another one of the tax implication. It is also covered when the future contract purchase fructifies into a sale count cumulates into delivery. There should be liability payment subject. So these are all the tax related. No need for yours. I can go for next slide. There are favorable tax rates commodity that taxes 60% of long-term capital gain, 40% of short-term capital gain. So this is the basically the tax slab also will be applicable. So yes, so this is the very important chart in the commodity exchanges and the entire commodity market, how it is to be controlled. For example, I already told a Ministry of Consumer Affairs, Ministry of Consumer Affairs, basically controlled by the central government. Later on, it will be controlled by FMC, the Forward Market Commission. The Forward Market Commission entirely controls the commodity exchange. Commodity exchange classified two aspects. One, it is national exchange. Another, one is regional exchange. Firstly, let us discuss national exchange, NCDX, MCX, NMCX. NCDX, all of you know, is National Commodity Derivative Exchange. MCX, Multi-Commodity Exchange. NCDX, NMCE, National Multi-Commodity Exchange. So these are all the major three commodity exchange in the National Stock Exchange, National Commodity Exchange we have. Regional Stock Exchange, 20 other regional stock exchange and the NBOT like also you have. So these are all the major regional commodity exchanges we have. It is very important thing you have to understand the concept. Let us go for next thing, Indian commodity exchanges. So let us go for basically Indian commodity exchanges dealing with the, which are the, what are the major commodity exchanges we have. The East India Cotton Association, Surendra Nagara Cotton Oil, the East India, the Spices. Like these are all the basically commodity related, commodity as well as agricultural product and whatever the cotton related product also dealing with. These are all the Indian commodity exchange as well as regional stock exchange, regional commodity exchange we can consider over. So these are all the things you have to, National Board Trade Limited, Chamber Commerce Limited. So these are all the major only we have to understand in that commodity exchange. So these are all the related of the commodity. So thank you. Thank you very much.